I remember reading about the part of murder. I used to be the only nigga reading murder dogs. I used to read. So when I got out, I started, you know, trying to look for some of the music that I was reading about and shit. And then that song came out for Swinging Texas. That's my first song. From that point on, I was like, this nigga dope. I like the flow, the fast flow. He's really bogging this shit. Like, that's why I know the Power Magazine, because I correlated you with the reading about your murder dog. So when, recently, you know, my man Terrell just told me, like, yo, you know, we're doing tech now. Tech that dude. And this was like 6 months ago. I was like, yo, man, I don't know how to connect. It's funny because I just did a show and I ran to Vanessa. And she was like, yo, you from Man of Tech now? Like, your name just keep coming up. That's why I said, when I hear shit like that.
Would you like some coffee?
Yeah.
And check now.
You hear that shit, you know, it's like going on something phenomenal, you know what I'm saying? I've seen this shit happen a few times. The artists, when you hear the game 3 times a week, 4 times, 5 times. Next thing you know, next thing you know, it's going to fuck his household name. It's your time, bro.
Like, it usually happens like that. Like, whenever something happens, like, everything just starts mysteriously, like, and next thing you're like, wow, how'd I get here? You know?
I think it's what's going to happen here, because it's going to take a lot to finish it up. You're going to look around one day and be like, oh shit, you know?
I mean, you're going to be where you want to be, because, like, also, how you're doing. Y'all don't work in a kiss-ass way either.
So it's have to.
When they know you, they respect you more than anything, and that respect is one thing that takes you further. So it's like having respect for a person.
Tell them what Zena told you.
Zena told me, he was like, yo, I just did a deal with Kevin Zena.
Kevin's my dude.
He told me, he was like, yo, you know, he's giving me the sales pitch about his label. And I just left the majors and shit, right? So he's like, what we do, there's only one other label to do it better than we do. That's Strange Noise. Like, they the only label besides, like, they the only guys that do it better than we do.
That's dope, man. They've been doing it for longer than us. It's nice for them to acknowledge us, man. I really like Kevin. I think there's a lot of other people that add to the mix up there, like Benny and a whole bunch of folks over there, man. But you know, we work with them. We have a tour that we all own together called Strange Noise. We just took Suburban Noise and Strange Music and put it together. So we've been doing an annual tour with that. We got a variety of other shit that we do, a lot of collaborations and that type of stuff. But you know, I study what they've done, and I try to evaluate what somebody does very well, what they may, you know, leave on the table, what they may do poorly, and just apply it to the best of our ability to what our model is. I look at what all these records do, all these record companies, from Up Down fucking to Psychopathic Records and that Juggalo shit, just trying to pay attention, like, how did they train all of these hundreds of thousands of kids to buy every fucking shirt they produce? How did that go down? And then try to implement it in a way that makes sense and fits our image and our look. And we didn't.
That's why I did the deal with them, because I'm like, we could both introduce each other to a whole other world. I got that urban street shit on Spanish. Yeah, I got the whole shit I don't know nothing about. They got a whole other fucking thing going on. And I'm like, I need to be a part of that. You know, I could bring y'all over here. We make these worlds collide and shit.
Well, that's how it's supposed to be. George Clinton said, one nation under a group.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's how it's supposed to be, man.
Exactly. And to see, like, in the C had PE, I just seen him for the first time before.
This was crazy.
That motherfucker had his elbow. Jaws were random shit going down.
Jared getting ramped up, though.
That motherfucker had his motherfucker. Wow. I was like,
you know Brother Jay still over there? You know Brother Jay still over there?
Oh, with Cottonmouth King?
Brother Jay was signed.
Brother Jay. On the show.
X-Clan.
Oh, yeah,
he was signed over there. We were on tour with him and everything.
They're managing a lot of people too. They're managing they're starting to pick up more and more stuff. But they're trying to get
So
we'll see what happens.
We'll see what happens. Yeah, bro. When you got the when you want, I need to hear some beats soon, man.
We can do that before you leave, man. How long y'all here?
Friday.
Friday.
Oh, shit, that ain't bad. There's only what, two things? Mm-hmm. And sometimes you start forgetting the days of the week, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Sometimes. I got some beats on the iPod. Come on, man.
Huh?
I got some beats on the iPod.
I got some shit that's in the making. Like, I ain't on front. Like, I look at it, like, I've been bored with this shit for a while, but now I'm like, you know. I've been starting to feel it the past couple of weeks. I got some ideas. Mm-hmm. To me, it's a matter of like always coming up, always being able to keep pushing.
Inspiration,
the ball.
Man.
I remember you did some monumental shit for me. We did some shit called Turn.
Yeah, we did something.
Yeah, we did. It's like some movie soundtrack shit.
Yeah, like I was bugging. Like I Trav never sent it to me. Some kid on what's that shit on Twitter hit me.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, oh man, that's been my. It's like yo. I DM him like, yo, can you send me the record? I've been dying to get this record. And dude sends it to me and it's like, I was like, oh man, this shit is crazy. Because it's like, even listen to everything else, and I think Trav said this before, it doesn't sound like none of the other stuff that you've really been doing.
Okay.
So I think the one thing I say, even like, working not just in the United States, even working overseas, man, like music is the background, so it's like, it has no language, so it's like, you can work with anybody, you can make anything work. You know, it's just like, yo, like you say, you know, George Clinton, what they say, one nation under group. When you look at Parliament and Funkadelic, where they came from, even Bootsy and a couple of other these dudes, yeah. Like, they came from James Brown, which is a whole different type of funk.
Yeah, it is.
So it's like, they just transform it. It's like, the one thing that a lot of cats that produce don't really understand is the music. Mm-hmm. Music transforms from one to another, but it still has to have that feeling and that groove. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you can make music in the South, you can make music in New York, you can make music in Canada, no matter where you're from. Like, if you have a sound, it's one common denominator that everyone will feel. And it's like, I think, kind of like, when they was talking about that, like, that was where it was at. Because even listening to, like, Parliament and Funkadelic, during the times people like, yo, when they was on Westbound,
yeah.
The music is really ill, and it's kind of intricate. And it's like, if you really into music, you get it. But mm-hmm. some dudes, if you ain't into music, you're like, yo, what the fuck is it? You know? But I can appreciate it.
Yeah.